Let's check on European markets first. They're mixed as weak services sector data from China and the Eurozone fueled concerns about slowing global growth. The German DAX and the French CAC 40 both down, while the London's FTSE 100 is seeing modest gains on data showing retail sales rose 4.1% in August as inflation eased and consumer confidence improved. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a lower open as U.S. markets return to trade from the Labor Day holiday. Goldman Sachs moved to lower the chances of a U.S. recession in the next 12 months to 15% from 20, has failed to lift sentiment. The investment banking giant says one of the key factors of that optimism is that the Federal Reserve is likely done with raising rates.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Qualcomm after it said it will supply chips to power the in-car infotainment systems of Mercedes and BMW. Shares of the U.S. chipmaker are, however, down 0.6% in pre-market trade. Also in focus, shares of Tesla after its Shanghai division sued a Chinese firm over tech secret infringement and unfair competition disputes. Shares of the American EV maker are up 0.6% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Renault. That's after its CEO Luca Di Meo said Renault's Ampere EV division could get a valuation of up to 10 billion euros. Renault Group shares are trading in the green at 35.38 euros apiece.
Asian markets ended Tuesday trade on a sour note on disappointing data across the region. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led decliners, dragged further by property stocks. The South Korean KOSPI closed flat but in the negative after inflation in Seoul climbed for the first time this year to 3.4%. The ASX 200 also finishing flat after the Reserve Bank of Australia offered no surprise and kept key rates unchanged for the third straight month in a row in Philip Lowe's last rate-setting meeting as governor. Bucking the downswing, the Nikkei 225, which closed at a one-month high after Japan's service sector activity expanded at its fastest pace in 3 months. Japanese steelmaker JFE Holdings, however, plunged 6% on news it is planning to raise 121 billion yen through a share offering. Here at home, Philippine shares picked up some gains, even as inflation rose for the first time this year. First Metro Investments' Christina Ulang says investors are taking the data in stride after a difficult month for the local bourse.
You know, the PCE was unfortunately hit by so many negative factors, a confluence of events, it's ghost month. So all of this confluence of negative events dragging the PCE 6,002. But I think the investors now are very much relaxed because they're already there at the seeming bottom. I'm not sure if this is the bottom, but it seems the investors are taking it in stride. Or let's just be at 6,200.
With rice among the biggest driver of food inflation, the country's chief economic planner is now calling for a review of existing tariff levels on the staple grain. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacat says government may consider a temporary and calibrated reduction in tariffs to help lower the cost of rice while taking into account its impact on local producers. Meanwhile, House lawmaker Stella Kimbo has filed a bill seeking to empower President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to declare a state of national rice emergency. Under that bill, the president can pay out rice subsidies, authorize limited imports, and prescribe penalties for acts of economic sabotage involving the staple grain.